For the last 3.5 years, Steamboat Geyser here has thrilled dedicated geyser watchers and just occasional park visitors with huge eruptions, water, steam, mud, and even rocks shooting 300 feet into the air.
Well, it looks like Steamboat's slowing down.
On September 11th, Steamboat had a major eruption. That was the first one in 65 days. Up until May, the geyser had been erupting on average every 5 to 10 days since it came back to life in March of 2018.
This is one of those aspects of geysers. Most of them are really unpredictable, so you have to enjoy it while you can.
Steamboat is having a good long run. It erupted 32 times in 2018, 48 in 2019, and another 48 in 2020, including one huge eruption of 355 feet. But so far this year, Steamboat has had just 14 major eruptions. So what's happening?
And there's no clear sign of what's different now versus the way it was 5 years ago.
Or, for that matter, a century ago. Steamboat went dormant for 50 years from 1911 to 1961.
So one thing we do know is that it has to have a lot to do with the subsurface plumbing system, the geyser conduits, whether or not they're constricted or more open. And that's something that is very difficult to understand because we just can't see down there.
But Poland has a hunch.
I still feel like water availability has to have something to do with it, having high levels of groundwater, because there was a lot more rain and snow a few years ago than there has been the last couple of years.
The parking lot here at Norris Geyser Basin is busy today, as it has been for the last 3.5 years since Steamboat Geyser began erupting again. It's so busy, in fact, that the Park Service created more parking places out along the main highway, a little walk from here, and it has rerouted traffic in this area to keep vehicles moving along. Now, if Steamboat goes dormant, does that mean people won't be coming anymore? Hard to say, but Norris has always been a popular spot, and it is home to the most active geyser basin. So even if the big geyser isn't going off, there's still a lot to see. In Yellowstone National Park, John Shearer, MTN News.